Hi, this is Eva Cartman, host of the Dream Big podcast show, the place to go to learn, laugh, and grow. In today's episode, I wanted to talk to you about a concept I learned from an incredible man by the name of Jesse Itzler. My family and I have been following Jesse for a while now, and honestly, he has more fun and does cooler things than anyone I know of. And it turns out that there's a reason why. What Jesse is doing is very intentional, and I want to share this incredible strategy which can change your life. This is episode 206 of the Dream Big podcast. It's time to dream big.
My name is Eva Cartman. I'm part of a squad of super kids that are here to change the world. We don't believe you need to be adults to have big goals and start working towards your dreams. We believe age is just a number, and you're never too young to make a difference. We may be young, but we are not naive. We understand that achieving our big dreams will not be easy. It will take incredible dedication, hard work, and yes, massive action. There will be ups and downs, but we embrace the challenges and relish pushing outside of our comfort zone because this is how we grow. They may not teach us these concepts in our school textbooks, but we are smart enough to know that the tools and tactics to achieve our big dreams are out there. And we are willing to do the work to seek out these skills and master them because we know that our future depends on it. We are the big dreamers, and it's time to dream big.
Before we dive into this week's content, here's some jokes from Silly Sophia.
Why was the balloon white? It overslept. Not slept, but swept. How does a train eat? It goes chew, chew.
Thank you, Sophia. Today, I wanted to share a concept that I learned from Jesse Itzler. You may recall I did an episode about Jesse's book, Living with a Seal, last year. That's when Jesse decided it was a good idea to invite the toughest person on the planet and Navy SEAL, David Goggins, to live in his home and follow all of his orders for 31 days. It's an incredible story, and I encourage you to listen to that episode if you haven't already. I'll include a link in the show notes. But what's so cool about Jesse is that it's just one of the countless unique experiences that he can write a book on. Actually, he wrote one on how he lived with monks. And if you just scroll through his Instagram, just about every weekend he's doing something epic with his family or friends. Just a few weekends ago, he and some friends participated in a race called Mid-State Mile, where runners had to complete 1 mile within 20 minutes. Now that might sound like plenty of time, but each mile included 340 feet of climbing, and runners would have to repeat the mile every 20 minutes until one person was left. The winner was the last person standing to be back to the starting line to run another mile. Again, these are just a few examples. Every weekend, it seems like Jesse is doing something that most people would never do. Whether it's going into icy cold water or getting on stage in front of thousands of people. Jesse calls this concept building a life resume. Now, to be honest, at the age of 11, I didn't even really know what a resume was. And it turns out that most people who hear the word resume think about a work resume. When you're applying for a job, you share a work resume to potential employers to show the work experience you have. But what Jesse is talking about here is not a work resume, but a life resume. What are the experiences that you can put on your resume from life? The cool things you did, the places you visited, the challenges and races. I love this concept of life resume. When you think about your life and you're asked to think of memories that come to mind, those tend to be fun, unique experiences, right? Well, why not challenge yourself to just always be building your life resume? Always adding to that experience list that you can look back at and cherish. For me, I realized that I've been working on my life resume, from launching this podcast, to rapping at a school talent show, to being in a musical, to running Spartan races. Each one of those unique experiences has helped me grow and shape who I am as a person. Even during COVID-19, I'm looking for new and fun ways to build my life resume. For instance, I just learned how to ride a unicycle. I develop a passion for baking. My dad and I have been challenging ourselves to go on longer and longer bike rides together, beating our previous records. While we are not traveling right now on planes, we did do a camping trip a few weeks ago near Santa Barbara, which is about a 1 hour drive from where I live. The campground had a hike to a llama pasture, and we spent a few hours being with those incredible creatures. I'm sure by now that you get the point. What if you made it your goal to start building your life resume? What experiences could you have? What new cool things could you do? How would you grow? I'll tell you, it is super exciting to have the mindset of building your life resume because you are always dreaming up new ways to do something new and exciting. And then actually getting it on the calendar and making it happen is just amazing. I want to thank Jesse Itzler for this incredible idea that has shaped my life and my parents' life, who are also working on building their life resume, which of course, since I'm still living with them, is impacting my life resume as well. I encourage your family to follow Jesse's work. He is one of those people that you can really tell loves life and loves people and is striving to be the best version of himself, which is so inspiring. And I hope that one day Jesse will join us on the Dream Big podcast so we can all learn more from his incredible life story. Did you enjoy this podcast? If so, please do leave me a review at dreambigpodcast.com/iTunes and tell your friends and family. We do read your reviews and really appreciate the kind words. And if you haven't already, have your parents claim the Ultimate Personal Growth Resource Guide for Kids. Over 50 hours of my favorite interviews and solo episodes at dreambigpodcast.com/resources. That's all for today. This is Eva Cartman reminding you that you have unlimited potential. Your dreams are not optional, you need to make them essential. So take massive action to turn those big dreams into reality. Live with passion the way life was meant to be. I'll see you next episode. Bye.